This tutorial is part of my course on Udemy. Check out the description for more info. Hey there, in this lecture we're gonna work on the player's movement. I'll open Game Maker. I'll create a new project and select Game Maker language. Here I'll name it Crafter. Now the project's been created. First of all, we need to set up some basic resources. So we'll make a sprite for the player, make the player object and set up the room. So I'll go to sprites and create one. I'll name it as player. I'll go to the sprites properties. I'll click here and here change its size to 32 by 32. And then I'll click on apply. So now we have a 32 by 32 sprite. Now I'll click on edit image. This opens the image editor. We're gonna create a simple placeholder sprite for the player. So I'll select the fill tool and fill the sprite with a white color. So we're gonna use this for now and we'll add the actual player sprites in a later lecture. Now for the origin, I'll make sure that it's set to middle center. And now I'll close it. Now I'll go to objects and create one. I'll name it OPlayer. In the object, I'll click here and assign this sprite to this object. Now I'll go to rooms and open the default room that we have here. First of all, I'm gonna go into the room settings and change the room size. Now I'll open the background layer. I'll go to the properties and click here to change the background's color. And now I'll open the instances layer. From the objects, I'll drag and drop OPlayer into the room. And now I'll close it. So now the basic resources have been set up. Now we can start coding the player movement. So I'll go to OPlayer. In the events, I'll add the create event. And in the event, I'll add this. Here I'm initializing some variables for the movement. This is the movement speed of the player. So currently, the player will move 1 pixel per step. Now these variables store the actual movement of the player on the x-axis which is horizontal and the y-axis which is vertical. Now I'll add the step event where we're gonna code all the movement. So I'll add this code for taking input from the arrow keys. Here I'm creating local variables for each arrow key. So we have right, left, up and down. They use the keyboard check function to get the key input. So these variables will be 1 if the key is held and 0 if it's not. Now we need to convert these input values into x and y axes. Input x gets the input on the x axis by subtracting the left input from the right input. So when the right key is held and the left key is not held, this is going to be 1 minus 0. So the result is going to be 1. Now when the left key is held, but the right key is not held, this is going to be 0 minus 1. So in that case, the result is going to be minus 1. Now I'm doing the same here for the y-axis. So pressing down will make it 1 and pressing up will make it minus 1. Now these input axes can be added to the instances x and y and the instance should move. But first we need to get the actual movement speed. So for that, I'll add this. Here I'm multiplying input x with the move speed and then applying the results to move x. And then I'm multiplying input y with the move speed and applying that to move y. Then finally I'm adding move x to the x variable and move y to the y variable. So in the end, move x and move y store how much the player needs to move. And then they are added to the instance's x and y coordinates. So let's run the game and test it. I can move around with the arrow keys. Now you also wanna be able to move with the WASD keys. So let's implement that. I'll go back to the player step event. Here we are getting the input from the right arrow key. So we should also be able to use the D key to move right. So after this function call, I'll write this. Now this keyboard check function checks if the D key is pressed. Here you need to use the ORD function if you want to get input from a letter key. Now here I'm using the OR operator. So it checks if the right arrow key or the D key is pressed. So the value of this variable will be 1 when you press either of these keys. So now I can do the same for the rest of the keys. So we have A for left, W for up, and S for down. So now I'll run the game. And now I'm able to move with the WASD keys. Now the next thing we need in this game is a camera. So the camera will follow the player and only show a part of the room. So we'll do that in the next lecture. Thanks a lot for watching. If you're interested in the course, check out the description. Make sure you subscribe for more tutorials, and I'll see you in the next one.